was pretty much, you know, a lot of people were displaced and lost their homes. So did Earth Day. That was our home.
That's right.
That was our home. And we found a new place, Bayview, and we love Bayview because of the water access, because of the big playground, because there's indoor and outdoor facilities. Uh-huh. We're also going to have a labyrinth, which is a walking meditation. Uh-huh. We have the Five Flags Dog Association, and they're going to set up an obstacle course, an agility course, and they're going to do a demonstration of square dancing with dogs. So you can bring your animals and have them go through their little obstacle course. The greyhound adoption people are going to be there and doing greyhound adoptions. But we are so excited to have Cynthia and the wolves there to bring awareness to the fact that they are an endangered species.
Yes.
And you wouldn't think that. I mean, I really had no idea that wolves were endangered.
No, I don't think I knew that either. How many wolves will you have?
We're going to bring Teton and Tahoe to Earth Day. They're amazing young ambassadors, and people will actually get to enter into the enclosure and sit with them and pet them and experience them up close and personal. Mm-hmm. But as Brenda said, it's all about educating people. You know, someone once said, we will only conserve what we love. We'll love only what we understand, and we'll understand only what we are taught. Mm-hmm. So educating and reaching out and affording young people and older people as well these experiences that they will be experiencing at this wonderful Earth Day event. It's going to be an amazing, amazing event, and we're very honored that we were invited to come this year. Thank you, Brenda.
To have you there.
Thank you.
I think each year, you know, it gets bigger and better. I mean, it's a wonderful, wonderful event.
Well, we're trying to reach as many people as possible in the mainstream community to educate and inspire, to improve the quality of our environment. We went through such a terrible, terrible time with Ivan. And yet we were still able to celebrate the Earth Day last year.
Yes. Yes, definitely. Anything, we have a little bit more time, so if y'all have anything else that you want to add, you know, feel free.
I know on the website it said you're always looking for volunteers.
Yes, we do have a great volunteer program at the Wolf Preserve. Our philosophy is one person can't change the world, but together in a collective effort, each one of us in our own little corners of the world, in our own circles of influence, doing what we can make a difference. And opportunities for volunteers are certainly available up at the Wolf Preserve. And you know, Margaret Mead one time said, never underestimate what the power of a spirited group of people when they come together, the difference that they can make. And I'm honored to know you ladies and see what you are doing over here Pensacola way. And it's an amazing work with full of amazing people who truly want to make a difference. The more people we meet at Seacrest, the more we realize the heart of the American people, truly, they want a clean environment. They want healthy forests and trees and waterways, and they want to keep the wildlife going and keep it alive. And I think that's truly the desire of the heart of the American people.
I agree. Now, you're in Chipley, right?
We're located in Washington County, 13 miles south of Chipley.
Mm-hmm. And so how long is that drive from Pensacola?
About an hour and 45 minutes, perhaps, depending on the traffic.
And so if someone wants to come up, then they can contact you by phone or on email or on your webpage. And then they come up and, like, spend the day. Or if there's a volunteer that wants to come, I would assume you have some kind of training.
Yes.
And probably some kind of screening process, I would imagine. You'd be real careful with your wolves.
Right, and we do. We can talk about that when they call. Mm-hmm. But we do have a great place to come and resonate with nature. Mm-hmm. And we have red-tailed hawks that nest on the property all of the birds and just all of the species. They're so important. You know that there's over 30,000 amphibians alone that are now extinct. And so it's amazing to learn that we can make a difference in all of these areas.
Well, the last I heard, our little Perdido Key mouse is supposed to no longer be there since the hurricanes.
Really?
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe somebody has found a mouse since, but last I heard...
The Perdido Beach mouse.
Yeah.
So perhaps a male and female somewhere have survived.
Yes.
And they will hopefully recover.
I hope so.
Find each other amidst the debris.
Yes. And I hear them. So they came from the Arctic, though, these particular wolves that you have.
Teton is an Arctic wolf uh-huh. that came from the Arctic area, uh-huh. and Tahoe is a gray timber wolf. That okay. is the main species mm-hmm. of wolf, mm-hmm. and the others are mostly subspecies mm-hmm. from the gray timber.
Well, now, you know, you hear about the lone wolf, but I had read that wolves are very social.
They are.
Aren't they more of a social?
Oh, they're so social. They're such social creatures. Wolves live in families called packs, mm-hmm. and they're led by an alpha male and female who bring order and stability to the pack. And in the wild, a pack can consist of up from 3 wolves up to 20-something wolves.
Wow.
But they are very social, mm-hmm. and they do crave companionship mm-hmm. and...
So I wonder where that turn, you know, that idea of the lone wolf came.
There are many myths floating yeah. around out there now. Sometimes a young wolf will break off from a pack mm-hmm. and wander off to start his own pack.
Uh-huh.
And perhaps that might be.
Maybe that's the lone wolf. Oh, well, thank you all so much. Do you have anything else you wanted to add? Or
I would like to say, once again, okay. Earth Day Pensacola is April 22nd, which is mm-hmm. a Saturday from 10 to 5 at Bayview Community Center and Park.
Excellent.
Free admission, lots and lots of activities to do. Tons of information is going to be made available from city, from county, from states, and from federal agencies.
Wow. Yes.
Just tons and tons of information. A good time for everybody. A good
yes,
time for
the
everybody.
The whole family.
The whole family is welcome.
And
your dog and your pets. Yes. There's 2 doggy parks there. So you can come and bring your animals. But we're also looking for volunteers.
Oh, yes. Okay.
Yes.
Wonderful. You hear
and
that? Volunteers.
Yes. Volunteer for Earth Day. Get a free t-shirt. We love our volunteers.
Yes.
We love our volunteers.
Yes.
So in all information about Earth Day is on our website, which is www.earthdaypensacola.org.
Wonderful. Well, thank you so, so very much for joining us
thank
today.
Thank you, Bonnie.
Thanks to the wolves for coming. And thank you all so much for joining us on The Nature of Pensacola.